Good morning from Sao Paulo, Brazil. One of my clients is a few minutes late. I just got done having a breakfast coffee. But I wanted to tell you about a situation that a dear friend is in that called me for help. My friend is a contractor who works with large contracts, and one of the things that just happened is my friend got a phone call. The phone call said, "We can't work with you anymore. We've had a great run with you, and now we're hiring someone else to do the same job." The problem my friend had was having only one client. It was a huge client. It was a whale client. It was a client that made a lot of money. But this is why when I talk to people, I don't really care whether or not you work for a company or work for yourself or an entrepreneur or a hustlepreneur, whatever you call it. Never put yourself in a situation where you only have one way to eat. If you have a 9 to 5, find out what you can do from 7 to 10. Because one of the worst things that can possibly happen is you're in a situation like my friend is now, who called me and said, "We need to get this resume tightened up before 2 or 3 days from now, because Monday I have a series of interviews looking for a new person to be my new benefactor." And I said, "No problem, I'm gonna get right on this." The problem that I'm having is it never should have come to this. I want everyone, and I'm not just pushing my product. Everybody knows I write resumes for people. And if you need a resume written, call me, contact me. But what I am telling you is that if you don't always have a situation as a backup plan, if things don't go right with the way I make money right now, one, you're not saving part of your money, but two, most importantly, you're arrogant in your belief that you're indispensable or that the people that you work with suddenly are going to make sure you're taken care of forever. The only person who's going to make sure you eat is you, period, all the time. Not me, not the person who's paying you right now. I don't care if you have a giant client that's paying you a ton of money. You need to have a couple of other smaller clients just to keep your skills sharp so that you don't find yourself in a situation where the only thing you know how to do, stop the show, we got a quick plan going over. You need to make sure that you have everything set up so that the only thing you have to worry about is who do I call if one of my clients walks away. And if you don't need the extra money, because there's no such thing as extra money, but let's say you have a client that's giving you everything you need. You don't need any more money. Fine. Save the money. Go back and look at some of my other videos on cryptocurrency and Bitcoin. If you're making a little bit of money on the side, I don't care if it's just an extra $100 a month. Put that money someplace special. I just wanted to share this with you because my heart is breaking right now. Because my friend, who went from all these professional highs, just called me and said, "I need to hire you. I need you to fix my resume." Because I wasn't prepared for the client that I had, the whale that was feeding me, to go away. I don't have anybody else I'm working with. I don't have anybody else that I can just say I can increase the amount of time and attention I spend with you because the other client that I had has gone away. I try to operate that way. I don't ever put myself in a situation where any one person, thing, organization can say if I stop interacting with YusefWateef, he's not going to get this anymore. You know, and there's a serious power in that kind of freedom. Freedom is something I want to talk about a little bit later. I listened to a podcast that Dr. Cornel West had that he was a guest on, and we're going to dive into that later because they talk a little bit about the concept of freedom. Part of freedom isn't just being able to say, "I don't need anyone." Part of freedom is being able to say, "Anytime I do need someone, I can find it." One of the reasons that I work my ass off for all my clients is because I'm not the only wolf in the forest. I know I'm not the only dragon in the sky. I know there's somebody out there just like me, just as talented, charming, and handsome without the luxurious mustache as I am, who's saying, "I want that client. I want to be the person editing your newspaper. I want to be the person editing your journal. I want to be the person writing for your website as a ghostwriter. I want to be the person writing resumes." So I work my ass off with every client I have so that they feel like, "Well, I must be the only client you have." And I tell them, no. I have many clients. But I hustle my ass off for every single one of them because I know I have competition. Let me know in the comments. As I always say, the big thing I need you to do for me is share this on some social media. I don't care if you copy the link and post it on Facebook and be like, "Hey, this guy's a genius," or, "Hey, this guy has no idea what he's talking about." I don't care if you post this link on Twitter. I don't care if you put it in a WhatsApp group or a WeChat group. I don't really care, but the two things I need is for you to give it a thumbs up or a like and share it somewhere, because I've had a lot of great feedback from some of the things I've given people, and I'm glad to give it to you. I hope all you guys are having a great morning. Bye-bye.